Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the North Carolina Tar Heels and the Florida State Seminoles. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Seminoles should be in for what looks like an insurmountable battle, Dick. What are the keys for them to get a victory tonight?
Well, there's a few things that they absolutely have to do. Number one, play it your style. Don't get roped into doing things that you normally don't do. You must be in control. Next, don't let them get too many open looks from beyond the three-point line. Lastly, win the battle on the glass. That's going to be huge tonight. Boy, that stat at the end could be a big one.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. The skip pass is picked off. The point guard handles the pass. Both teams looking to get things going here. Inside, pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Inside. The fake. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul. Then.
He's out of control, baby, out of control. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
And he scores despite the hack. He draws a foul. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
High post flashes for the opportunity. Fed the low block. The ball goes out of play. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Looking for contact. Number 50 with a finger roll. Down in the low post, defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying and filming. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
Number 50 is emotionally fired up.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Trying to pack it inside. There's the fake. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Number 21 receives the ball, kicks it out. Looking for a good shot. They work it around the perimeter. And the ball goes out of play. He's got a high post flasher. Tries for two. In and out. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And back they come the other way. He'll regroup the offense. Gave it up.
Dump it inside.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Number three handles the feed. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Moving it around the perimeter. He tries the three. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
That spin move not successful, Dick, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Way off target. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Needed breather with that timeout. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. He fires it up. He hits the shot. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were...
Blocks it. Number 23 receives the pass. From the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
The Tar Heels are at the top of the ESPN polls, which means everyone else will be trying to knock them off.
Everybody wants to bring down the Giant. It's the old David versus Goliath saga. So all those top-ranked teams out there, be careful.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And he'll kick it back outside. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid is responding in a positive way.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad. The pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
He wants a three. He puts in another score.
He can see the light, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He shoots from downtown, way off target. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Looking for the foul. He went right through that double team.
And let's see if they decide to double next time down.
There's a whistle and a foul on the inside.
What a great job of putting the ball to the floor and attacking the basket, taking advantage of a slow post play.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. He's got an open look for the shot.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Stop and pop.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Let's it fly. Way off target. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He gets the rebound. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot.
That'll take some pride on a defensive end.
Definitely a foul. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Stolen away. With a light steal attempt, the defense is looking to gain possession of the ball.
In addition to the pressure defense, they're going for some aggressive steals as well.
Shoots from the top of the key. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. They work it around the perimeter.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well.
They work it back to the outside. Boy, terrible execution on offense. And the ball goes out of bounds. Check it out, Mr. Vitale. This young man is fired up. Look, he wants the crowd to show some love.
Pump them up, young man. Pump them up. Shooter spotting up on a three.
2-for-1 opportunity. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. And he'll kick it back outside. Top of the circle. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Drops the bucket despite the harm. Shot clock is dead. The circle, they work it around the perimeter. Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
He looks at the hoop.
That's a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
He looks for the bomb. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
And halftime, the Seminoles lead by 3. We've had a tooth and nail battle so far, Dick. What was the play of the half, do you think?
Watch some of the great inside work in the first half, Brad. The trick is whether or not they can keep going inside like that in the second half.
It's time to get back to the court, Dick, and see how their second half plays out. North Carolina coughed up the ball way too many times in that first half, Dick.
They certainly did, Brad. I've said it a million times. Turnovers kill momentum. I don't see a lot of these kids taking my advice out there. Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots out of the interior.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Erin. Looking for a screen on top and got it. And he scores it off the glass. They work it around the perimeter. The small forward takes the pass.
Awesome job of running his guy into the screen to get off that J.
Now they'll bring it up. The ball goes out of bounds. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards, keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
Picked off. On the dribble, gives it up. Picks off the pass. And now there's a whistle and a foul. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
Here's a flash from the high post. He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
The ball handler might be in trouble here. Now the high screen. Moving it around the perimeter. The fake. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move. And he does it exceptionally well.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you know, great post play, you got a chance really to win.
Got the high pick. Goes up for two.
Good offensive rebound. Nobody blocked out.
Tries for two. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I tell you, defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. Set that screen away.
Trying to draw some contact.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Lobs it inside. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. It rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Good athletic move. Very athletic. He's got great athleticism.
On the outside, he gives him the fake. The ball goes out of play. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Controlling the ball. Stolen ball. Gave it up. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
He uses the shot fake. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
And the ball goes out of play.
Double team now, bad angle.
He drains it. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Look the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Number 22 steps to the line for the first time. Sinks it.
Nothing but nylon, NBN.
Makes the third shot.
Brad, this place will be deafening if they can score here.
What a response.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it. Hey, one basket, Brad. If they can get some points here, the crowd will be extremely happy.
For two, it'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'm telling you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position, spreading his body and getting the ball. Pressure that basketball.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here he is defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
Entry pass in the paint. And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Takes the feed. He shoots. Can't get it to go. On the outside, the point guard gets the ball. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
They'll work it around the arc. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
In the paint. He fakes the shot. Here's a double team. Robs him of the ball. They push it up on the break. For the deuce. Off the rim and no good. The point guard with the ball. Gave it up. Number 40. It's good. He drew the foul off the hard take to the hoop.
Nice job, young man.
He is going to the line. Hits that one. Look out. Defender nailed by a screen. The pass in the paint. There's a double team waiting there for the bucket, and he missed. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He tries the three ball. We've got a timeout. Dick and I will be back in a moment.
That's a good TO, baby.
Some game plan changes, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad. The lead is up to 8.
They could be starting to pull away here, Dick. He shoots from right of the circle. Makes the shot. With a jump hook. Can't get the shot to drop. Tries for 2. Off the mark. Jumped in front to take it away. He shoots from the top of the circle. Rims out. Got it. The pass. Cross court. Steals the pass. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either. We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to 4. Got an open look if he wants it. He looks for 3.
They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick. Isn't it a clock management here?
Right, Brad. They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Continue to foul to stop the clock. Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in the game at the end drops significantly.
It's good. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the arc.
Number 25 wants even more support from the fans, Dick.
He wants everyone up for the next possession.
Got a nice screen. Got a guy right up on him. He shoots from outside. Off the rim and no good. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's kind of got home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, and you look at it and analyze it because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Seminoles opened the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.